In today's video, I'm going to talk about Galen and discuss about a spec for testing a simple page. Talk about how to use Docker so I don't have to install any of the requirements needed by Galen, and test against Selenium Grid using Browser Stack and Sauce Labs. So let's start. Galen is a test framework that can be used for layout and functional testing of web applications. Those tests can be run locally against your own local browsers or against Selenium Grid as well. I'm going to test a simple page created using Vue.js and TensorFlow.js. In particular, I am going to test that the input fields are next to each other and that the plus and train buttons are one above the other. Also, I'm going to test that the text inside a field has a particular string. For that, I am going to use a simplified version of the Galen sample tests, which demonstrates some of the features of the Galen framework. For the tests, we have the following structure from bottom to top. A shell file to make it easier to run the tests without having to remember all the parameters. A galen.config file in which I define that the default browser is Chrome and the path to the chromedriver.exe file. The chromedriver.exe file needed for running tests locally, which can be downloaded from chromedriver.chromium.org. A JavaScript file with the extension .test.js inside the tests folder that we'll call the gspec file with the tests to perform. A file for initializing some options used in most tests, like the breakpoints to be tested, the website root URL, etc. Galen Bootstrap, which is a simple JavaScript layout testing framework based on Galen framework. Then, inside the spec folder, we have a simple gspec file called TensorFlow, which first defines the objects that I am going to test, an object for the X inputs and another one for the Y inputs, one for the plus button and one for the train button, and a final one for the prediction text. A section for the fields for training the model, a loop that will go through each XY value pairs and check that they are next to each other, and a single check that makes sure that the train button is below the plus button by 20 pixels. And a section for the fields for predicting using the model, in which I am only going to test that the click on train text is present. And finally, we have the Galen extras folder, which is a library for extending the Galen spec language with some common expressions. First, let's try Galen locally. For that, you will need to have it installed. I'm going to use npm for that. Also, for it to work, you have to have Java installed as well. For running the tests, I just need to call Galen and pass the folder in which the JS tests are located and the folder for the HTML reports as well. We can see that everything was successful. Also, we can see the report in a web format by opening the report.html file located under the newly created reports folder. So now let's execute our tests, but this time let's use Docker instead. One caveat here is that we don't have access to the browsers installed in our host. One way to solve this is to use Selenium Grid. I created a Docker file for this. First, I start our new image from a clean Ubuntu one. Declare the workdir as, well, workdir. I know, I am original that way. Install OpenJDK and then Node.js. And finally, install Galen framework like we did locally. Define the entry point as Galen so that we can override the parameters from the command line And just to have a default behavior, let's add a CMD instruction and just add minus minus help. Let's build the image so that we can instantiate the container. We can test that the Galen framework container is working by just trying to run the container, which will show the help text as we defined on the Docker file. So now let's try to execute our tests using our new container. As I mentioned before, we don't have access to any browser on the host, and I didn't install any on the Galen container either. Let's now use Selenium Grid for this. First, let's go to Browser Stack and sign in into your account or sign up for an account if you don't have one already. Then go to Account and then Settings and find the Automate section. Copy your username and access key. Now let's enable Selenium Grid using the command line. And also, let's add the URL for Browser Stack's Selenium Grid using also the username and access key from before. For SOS Labs, we need the same information, so head to their site and sign in, or well, get a free trial. Then click on your username and then user settings, and copy your username and your access key as well by clicking on Show. Now let's do the same as before and enable Selenium Grid and the URL for SOS Labs and also the username and access key you just copied. Awesome! Congratulations and thanks for watching! And if you like the video, please hit subscribe.